Hey everybody, welcome back to Prayer Walk number 4. This is the last in the series, I promise. And this vlog is going to be all about resources. A little construction update here in Lorac. Here's the city center, and they took that whole building down. It's now one big pit, and they're going to be building a massive building. I don't know how many stories, but stay tuned. I'll send you photos and videos as it happens. You know, that might not be so true, because by the grace of God, that'll be another vlog coming out. I might be leaving Lorac down the road and going to a little city, little village called Jestetten. It's just above Zurich, Switzerland, and I'll keep you updated on those details. So if you're one of those high-impacting, intentional Christians, and you want to start prayer in your little area, maybe you want to make some cards. I made these a long time ago. Our organization just made these for me for Switzerland, and on the back is just some prayer ideas. So make some little cards, hand them out, and ask people to pray.
As you know, the Bible is the best resource on prayer.
I wanted to share this briefly about prayer. Sometimes our mentality gets a little bit mixed up. You know, we think that we're in a lazy boy recliner and we don't have to worry about so much. It's just sort of peacetime. But my friends, I think the church is just not that luxury liner in life sailing across. I think the church should be a wartime vessel carrying troops. Friends, we are in a war. Now, you're probably like, well, what are you talking about? Well, if you want to know more, you can send me an email. But my friends, there is a spiritual battle happening. Why else in Ephesians chapter 6 would Paul give us that armor? You know, the belt, the breastplate, the feet ready with the gospel, the shield, the helmet, the sword. My friends, we're in a time of war, and we need to help each other and encourage each other to be people of prayer by the grace of God.
I'd like to tell you about another great author on prayer. His name is Andrew Murray. He wrote this simple little book called With Christ in the School of Prayer. I highly recommend you purchase this book for your library or your Kindle. It will be the best couple of bucks you will have ever spent. Another great book to keep the fire coals of prayer burning hot is called The Valley of Vision. You know, if my plane crashed on an island for 1 year and I had two books with me, they would be the Bible and The Valley of Vision. You can easily get yourself a copy online.
Okay, my friends, really, thank you for tuning in to Prayer Walking, the whole series. Many of you were so encouraging. You had lots of ideas, thoughts. You wanted resources. That got me fired up. It should fire us up when other people start to pray, and they pray with us, and they have questions, and they want to know what the Bible has to say. It's so encouraging.
So, my friend, how would you characterize your prayer life experience? You do realize that prayer is a journey to get to know God better. Let's go the road together and encourage one another. Thank you again for watching and for praying for me. Lots of love to you.
So my friends, continue to pray for me. Us missionaries, as you know, we're on the front lines of ministry, and there is warfare. I'm grateful for your prayers, and we will stay in touch. See you next time. Auf Wiedersehen.
And that's right, I'm a Swiss wannabe.